So good evening to everybody. This is a round table. So we are going to discuss about the legalization of marijuana. There are several controversies about this legalization because many people think that it could bring problems to the countries and other things otherwise. So for that, we made a survey that helped us to find out how people think about this legalization. So according to survey that we made it to 100 people, and 67% are not agree with this legalization. So what do you think about that? Are you agree or not with this legalization?
Well, in my personal opinion, I think it should be legalized because it might have a lot of benefits in the country's population, such as it might help in a recreational way. It helps people who have cancer as a pain reliever. Also, it helps might help in the country's currency and many other advantages.
I don't think that it could help in your recreation, because when you are trying to win something in your recreation, what control you have to that recreation? What for you, what is the high thing that you can make it for recreation? Or also, how can you control that for the country gets some money from that? How you will put a tax? Or it's impossible. It's like trying to put a tax to what you eat, because nobody will control how many cigarettes you are smoking or how many of that you buy. So I think that's the problem, because if we want to legalize it, that is very difficult to put a tax. So we cannot see a benefit that is the putting that money to our country. And also we need to remind that all the marijuana is not produced in all the countries. How we know the facts that they gave us on the survey is that we know that marijuana is made in other countries, and other countries is only like a pass, like here in Honduras, that is from Honduras to United States. And what is the currency, or what money we get from, what money gets Honduras for that?
I do believe it helps in the income of a country, because if it is controlled by a state, then it does have taxes applied to it, then all of those taxes can be, they get into the money of the country, and it can be used for parks and railroads or anything in the country.
Well, I personally think that it could be legalized and it could not, but the main problem would be the acceptance of our Latin American culture, because we are very conservative, and so it would be very difficult for people to accept it, and there would be a lot of controversy, so it wouldn't be that easy.
Well,
I think the legalization of marijuana will bring good things and bad things. For example, a good thing is to reduce the violence in the country, and a bad thing can be increase the number of consumers.
So we're going to go to the next question. Okay, many people think that marijuana causes danger effects in your health, but what do you think about that? That can be true or not?
I think that is true, because I think that it has a very negative impact on the health of the people, because this alters all the system, the neural system, because you think that you do the things good, but your brain is not good, because all your neurons are altered, and for that reason I think that has a negative impact on your
health. Well, we hear he mentioned that it's also used for cancer, like a medication, but I think that that's in a case that we use in a small quantity. But here, like also they say recreation, drug trap, I think that that's a type of abuse that we should make. And how we know all abuse causes a damage in our body. And sometimes, like we could see, it's like alcohol, we even cannot control that. Imagine if drugs also were drawn in this case, it would be impossible to control that society, that type of things.
Well, as he also is mentioning, he's telling me that it might be an abuse of the marijuana, but what about alcohol that is a legal drug, and there's most cases of deaths with people are in consuming alcohol instead of consumption of marijuana. There's not even one death of a person who has consumed marijuana. Also, for the people who consume it, who has cancer, it's not only for the people who consume cancer, also for people who suffer like from a shoulder breakage, because it's a pain reliever and it's an antidepressant. So people consume it because for people who have disease or want to make themselves better. I know it's also in a recreational way, but we might need to conscientize the people on how to do it in a controlled way, not in excess.
And also if you compare it to a cigarette, it is less harmful for someone to be smoking weed around people than smoking a cigarette. It affects the other people around you more than yourself.
But we're going to talk about we're going to compare both things, cigarette and marijuana. So what do you think that is more harmful, snuff or marijuana? What can you tell me?
I believe it's more harmful to smoke a cigarette than marijuana.
Why?
Because in studies you can get cancer from smoking a cigarette, and from smoking weed you usually just use it as a recreation way or as a
well, I think that it will be different, because I think that the weed is inherently more that it has more damage in us. So you could see people could smoke driving, right? You see a lot. I think my partner is going to tell me that he smokes driving. I know many uncles, friends that they smoke driving. But I think that you could never see someone like driving with me, because you will see that the damage that it causes, that it's directly. Okay, how we know that cigarette is a damage that it will take a long time, like it goes like 15, 20 years, but the weed it's that immediately. It makes it like how she told us, that makes that your brain don't work good, so I think that it's more harmful than that.
I think that yes, it is true, but I think that people that regularly consume it, the body just like learn to like live with it, and they can actually control all the effects. And I think the effects are different for every kind of people.
But I think that if you are already making a people that is already consuming almost every day things that body is assimilating, they are already made it. They are. Yeah, they're already dependent on that, and always they would like to have that same feeling, so they will increase that dosage, I think. And that will be more harmful for them, and also will bring more problems to their life.
I think that better to smoke weed than cigarette, because the cigarette has many chemicals that damage your lungs and other things, and the weed is just natural.
Yeah, I support her opinion in which like cigarettes do have more like thousands of chemicals that make harmful and cause cancer in a long way. And even by one cigarette you consume, you need at least like 6 months to get it out, to get the smoke out of your lungs. Instead, smoking weed, you can also smoke it in a vaporizer. That is a healthier way, in which you're just smoking vape, so you won't have a harm inside yourself.
So with this legalization, could the marijuana consumption be reduced because people like what is for Biden?
Well, I personally think that at first it would increase the demand because people would be like very excited to do something that they had been prohibited for so long. But I think that eventually, like all things, it will not be something new, so people get bored of it or something, so they would start consuming it less because it's not like in its fashion, it's not new for them.
Well, I support that here because, like, you could see. What makes us to don't go and buy is that sometimes if you need to buy, you have a risk. And the risk is that you could get killed, or you could get, I don't know, maybe they know your name, then you could start receiving any phone call that you don't know. I mean, we don't know, many other problems. But if you have it in a supermarket, it would be like, oh, I'll go to buy it. Or it would be so easy to get that, that you will make that people get so I think that that would be.
I think it is good that it gets legalized because getting marijuana, you don't get it like from a store. You need to go like a drug dealer. So you get a lot of risks, like to get killed or robbed or anything, a lot of bad things. So if you can actually get access to it like in an easy way, like in a safe way, one, you may lose interest, yes, and second, it is like better for like in a big picture because it's like less bad. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Drug cartels and the black market will disappear. It only will be benefit by approving the legalization.
I think, in my opinion, for example, like a place in Poland is legalized. Most locals don't do marijuana. Most tourists do. So I think it will be a benefit because people seeing it as a normal thing being done. Because usually generations as they're coming, they're starting to do things. When they're prohibited to you, you do things because you're not allowed to do them. But once it might be allowed, people will see it like as a normal thing. And if it gets to be legalized, there should be people who have cards like medical cards and go take the amount of doses to smoking. So it won't be like the large amounts. It has to be like in a controlled way, so the population will get abused of it.
I think that more that to find out or to buy the marijuana in a little place, or society need to find more alternatives to no legalize marijuana or no legalize. I think that our society need to find more alternatives to protect or life in action of the drugs in general. I don't say that marijuana is a drug. I just say that more of that of to find to legalize or know the marijuana. We need to find alternatives to not consume. I mean, I say that to find a good farm to consume or commercialize that to protect our society, to protect our families, to protect our material rights.
In almost all countries exists the narcotraffic that produces violence, but if this law was accepted, do you think that could reduce the rate of violence or not?
Well, I definitely think that it would decrease the rate of violence because it wouldn't be like a black market. It wouldn't be that hard to find, so the drug dealers or wouldn't have it like the very hard way to commercialize it with everything, because since it would be legalized, it wouldn't be like very difficult to have in our hands, and that.
Well, we need to think that that's not the marijuana is not the only thing or the only drug that they are selling, that they are moving. They also have to find a new drug for being the black market. But we need to think that what happens? We need to think all the history that marijuana had before and now, that if we listen to news or we read, we always see that they are fighting, they are killing themselves, only for power and for have more person to sell them. So I think that doing what we do, we will never reduce that the violence, because they will try to find a way to produce that, because that keeps the cost of that product.
I think narco-traffic will come lower, because there will be special places where it will be sold instead of being sold in a non-legal way. And also, most people who smoke marijuana, there's been studies being made that most people aren't like violent. So
I think that the fact that there is barrier blocking the use of it makes these people, the drug dealers, give them power. So if you take the power away, they won't be like harmful anymore. So I think that it will decrease it, because marijuana consumers won't need from them. So
and I think that it will decrease crime, because I read something about since it was legalized in Colorado, the Uniform Crime Reporting Data from Denver says that there has been 10.1% decrease in overall crime from this time last year, and 5.2% drop in violent crime. So in Colorado,
well, using the fact that Yolanda told us now, that we could hear that, in Denver it reduced, but we listen and we read that the United States never produced. They are only the persons who make that consumption. But here, like for example, here in Honduras, that is a place where there is only a pass through. It's not only, we could hear that every day is increasing that murders. Every day of that type of violence. And that's also in our country that there is what they produce. We should hear that only for having that, they start killing militaries or police officers that make you or investigating that type of things.
So the legal sale of marijuana could benefit the country in an economic way?
I think yes, if it's controlled by the government and it's imposing taxes and giving away back to the people in the way of taxes, such as she mentioned, such as railroads or repairing cars. That's a way of giving back to the people their taxes, right? If it helps the economy of the country.
I would like to ask you, how you put a tax to that? How would be your idea of putting a tax?
For there will be a lot of people, the big amount, let's say, for example, in Honduras, there's a big amount of people who have cancer. So we'll give a card to, the government might need to give a card to each of these persons who have cancer so they can go buy it, and there's a tax imposed by the government for buying that thing. Or the government giving them such, just because having the disease of cancer, because it's a pain reliever, it will help them make themselves better. That's the way it gets imposed in taxes. Once we get it in taxes, then it has to be get it back by the government, such as the repairing of railroads or parks.
Well, but I have two questions there for you. The first one is, you're telling that they will have a tax for the person that are sick. Also, you are telling them that you are being sick, and also you need to pay a tax for being sick.
No, you pay a tax for consuming the doses of marijuana.
Yeah, but that's for you. That's not the only cure that for the better. But you will pay for getting better.
No, it's not getting better. It's just making yourself better.
Yeah.
So, I mean, marijuana won't be the cure for you.
Yeah.
But it will make you feel better.
But
it's a pain relief.
It's like when someone has cancer, does chemo, they pay for them. It's not like a free thing.
Yeah.
So in that, like, the amount you have to pay is not like just, it
yeah.
is not free. So
but
you do have to pay taxes, not just for chemo, for the hospital, for getting treated. So you do pay taxes.
Yeah, but have you already told us, like, my joint is only that I feel better. Chemo, you have a possibility of getting, of you winning the battle of cancer. So that's true. That's not for feel better.
But if you add that, with marijuana, I mean, chemo does have a lot of disadvantages. People
yeah.
are sick like all the time.
They vomit.
With
they
marijuana,
have headaches.
They don't feel those things.
They just consume marijuana to feel not the effects of the chemo.
Okay, and how will be your tax for the person that uses for recreation?
Like as meds? As buying meds for themselves?
Okay.
Like the tax will be implemented in like paying the paying the surgery. I mean, it won't be a big amount of tax because it's given by the government, but it has to have a little amount to, I mean, the government needs to keep producing it. And it might help like paying an extra from your budget, an extra tax. It might help in the production of the marijuana.
I think that only healthy economy if this product would be exported to other countries, because if it's an internal consumption, it won't be that high, or you won't have as much benefit as if you are exporting it to another country.
You think with exporting it, will be that around the world is the
right,
so you can export it to like any country. And there are not like a lot of countries that have legal.
But you would win more because it's like it would be more exclusive to have it. So it would pay more for something that is easy.
So the last question: if legalization were given, do you think teenagers should be allowed to consume marijuana?
I think that we'll get to the same problem with the alcohol. Like they are telling us we need to be 21 for drink. Here we are, for example, I'm not 21 for drink. That's true. And that they will put the same thing for drugs. They are going to put, well, for you for smoke, you need to be 21. They will never ask you already. You need to leave them. Well, we could think that maybe in the United States, but we need to think first of all in what country we are. And we think the type of society that we are. So we will always find the way for don't go by the bar. For going around it. So I think that's a true fact, that if we legalize it, the things will be start consuming.
I do believe that a fact of why teenagers usually have the urge to try it is because it is something that is prohibited.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do have an access to it, it will be like, okay, I may try it or I may not,
mm-hmm.
but I mean, I will think about if I really like it or I don't. Because usually most teenagers do things because they can't do it.
I have a question. How old are you? Did you already buy sometimes alcohol?
Yeah.
Okay, how many times?
Mm.
A lot. You can even count. Look, you can even count. It will be with the same with the marijuana, because you will buy and you will start buying, and it will be like the same that now. You even could count and you will start being a drug addicted or a marijuana addicted.
Depends on
it depends on every person.
Yeah, and I also think there should be an age limit, such as alcohol. Mm-hmm. It should be like at least 18, because if you're too young, you might have like precautions in your future, because you might open too much your mind, and you'll get. So it's better like to have an age limit such as alcohol, and it'll be safer. Like, I mean, alcohol causes a lot of harms in a way, in which marijuana doesn't have. I mean, it's not as much as dangerous as alcohol, because people do get more violent when they consume alcohol. People die. There's a lot of accidents by the consumption of alcohol. So I think it will be a good thing to make it legalized, but always taking in mind that they should have an age limit.
Well, as conclude, we can conclude that the key of the world, exactly word for me, is the over-control. So we have to have auto-control to consume some drug. So with all this, we can conclude that legalization of marijuana could bring good to the country, because it will reduce violence, drug dealing, or consumption. So thank you guys, thank you for your time. Good opinion for you.